Halloween. We all have our opinions about it, but here's the one thing you can't argue with. It is the one night of the year when we can transform ourselves into some crazy character, say to people, trick or treat, smell my feet, give me something good to eat, and get rewarded with candy. I love seeing all of the great creative costumes this time of year. You know, the ones where you look at them and you know exactly who they are. You get them. Then there are those who leave you puzzled. You look at them and think, who are you supposed to be, or what are you? Well, in the end, the best and the worst dressed get candy, but not all will leave with the satisfaction of knowing that they had rocked the character. When Jesus sent his disciples into the world, he did so with high expectations of them representing accurately and authentically his person and his character. When they came back to him, what did Jesus ask his disciples? How many people were in the crowds? No. How many people did you save? No. How much money did you earn for our cause? No. Listen to what he said. Now, when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he was asking his disciples, who do people say the Son of Man is? And they said, some say John the Baptist, and others Elijah, but still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. He said to them, who do you say that I am? Simon Peter answered, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. It seems that just about everyone but Peter didn't get Jesus. And that's because he didn't come as the conquering king and the political figure that they expected. And that's why later he said to his disciples to remain silent on his true identity, because he still had work to do, the work of the cross, where he would die for our sins, that he would be dead and then resurrected and sit at the right hand of God the Father Almighty to intercede on our behalf. So let me ask you this. Jesus sends you into the world today on this side of the cross. And does he ask us to remain silent? No. He tells us to tell the world about him, to accurately and authentically represent who he is. So I want to put forth a challenge for all of us this week. At the beginning of each day, hear Jesus say, who do you say that I am? As Christ followers, we know that he is the Son of God, God himself, who died on the cross for our sins so that we could spend eternity with him. But at the end of the day, hear Jesus ask you, who do they say that I am? In other words, as you go about your day, interacting with people in the world, family, coworkers, friends, fellow drivers, customer service representatives, cashiers, all of those folks with whom you interact throughout the day. Let's be intentional about representing Jesus in an authentic and accurate manner, so that at the end of the day, when Jesus asks us, who do they say that I am? We can respond, they say you are their Savior.